Hello, my name is Larissa, a registered veterinary technician with Aurora Animal Care Center. Today, I would like to take you on a walkthrough of a step-by-step dental cleaning with extractions. A patient service team member will admit your pet the morning of surgery. The doctor will perform a pre-anesthetic examination of your pet and review its current medical record. Pre-anesthetic blood work will be performed to ensure your pet is healthy and a safe candidate for surgery. Each anesthetic protocol is tailored specifically for your pet. The sedation will be administered. This will allow us to use less anesthetic medications during the procedure. After the sedation has taken effect, we will place an IV catheter. The IV catheter allows intravenous access throughout the surgery, and IV fluids are administered also. After the IV catheter is placed, the patient will receive an induction. Once the induction is given, the patient will be ready for intubation. An endotracheal tube will be placed that allows us to deliver oxygen as well as a gas anesthetic through their trachea and into their lungs, which helps maintain general anesthesia. We lubricate your pet's eyes while they are under anesthesia as they are unable to blink. Your pet is hooked up to the following anesthetic monitoring devices. The electrocardiogram, ECG, gives a real-time view of your pet's heart rate and rhythm. The capnography, anesthetic monitor, provides an end-tidal CO2 value and respiratory rate. The capnograph also provides a wavelength of every breath. Capnometers provide the end-tidal CO2 value and respiratory rate. Changes in rate and tidal volume give an indication of appropriate oxygenation and respiration. We use esophageal temperature sensor to monitor your pet's temperature during anesthesia. A blood pressure cuff is placed to monitor systolic, mean, and diastolic readings. A pulse oximetry with a lingual probe is placed on your pet's tongue. This is a non-invasive way to measure saturation of oxygen bound to hemoglobin, SpO2. To ensure that your pet stays warm during this procedure, we use a thermoregulation unit. A veterinary nurse will be right beside your pet monitoring vitals during the procedure and recovery. Using an ultrasonic scaler, we clean your pet's teeth. The ultrasonic scaler allows us to thoroughly remove plaque and tartar from the teeth, minimizing anesthetic time, and allows us to clean under the gum line also. Just like your dentist charts your teeth, we use a periodontal probe to use to measure pockets in the gums and tooth surface, checking for any root exposure. A dental chart is created to log any missing, chipped, fractured, mobile, furcations, and extracted teeth. Dental radiographs are performed to let us know what's going on below the gum line. If extractions are needed, we will place a dental nerve block. The nerve block is essential for oral extractions. It provides a basis of pain management by blocking the nerve by the tooth that needs to be extracted. Depending on the size of the tooth, the veterinarian may create a gingival flap. This will allow the veterinarian access to the bone and root surface. If the tooth is multi-rooted, it will be sectioned and the veterinarian will remove the roots and tooth and close the gingival flap with absorbable dental sutures. The teeth will be polished to remove any microscopic scratches to decrease the rate of bacteria sticking to the teeth or plaque buildup. After the dental procedure, we will remove the endotracheal tube once the patient is regaining their ability to swallow, among other reflexes. In the recovery phase, we trim your pet's nails and continue to monitor by checking vitals like pulse, temperature, and respiration. Your pet will continue to be monitored until he or she goes home with you. This concludes a walkthrough of your pet's dental procedure. Please contact us with any questions. Thank you.